everybody, it's Ashton here, and on today's video, I'm going to give you a quick introduction to Sketchbook Pro. It is my favorite drawing app that I use, or drawing program that I use when I'm doing anything digital, illustration, graphic recording, sketchnoting, anything digital at all, I use this program. This is the program that I use, I don't want to say 100% of the time. It's a pretty robust program, but it can be used in a very simple way, which is how I use it. So I just want to walk through a few ways to use it. I'm not going to go through absolutely every single feature that the program offers, but just a few things to really help you get started and hopefully decrease that learning curve for you a little bit. So I'm going to hop on my computer here. And let's just get into it. All right, I've opened up Sketchbook Pro. We're here just looking at a blank page. The first thing I'm gonna show you actually is what I always make sure that I do is I go up to image and I go to image size and I make sure that the size is what I want. So let's just type in 5,000 here. And you can see things adjust, but if you want a very specific size, just unclick keep proportions, and then you can see that only the one that you change gets edited. So let's just cancel this. You want to make sure that your resolution is high as well, at least 300 if you're planning on printing whatever it is that you're going to draw. So there's a little tip for you there. We're just going to keep it as is for today. Now, if you go up to window, you can see here that we have certain elements checked off. I always like to have the toolbar, which is this here. I always like to have the lagoon down at the bottom, which is outside of my screen image here right now, but that's okay. And the color puck, I don't often use the brush puck, but it's an option if you want. It's here to quickly change between brushes, but I prefer to use the brush palette, which is here. I'm just gonna pop it back up so you can see. And yeah, so I use the color puck a lot. If you just click on it, this black one will pop up. If you want that to disappear, you can just, just click this up here in the corner. And if there's a certain color that you already have on here and you want to go back to it, you can use the picker to go back. And if you want to have something, make something transparent, you can do that as well. A tip here, this is the layers function. If you want the background to be layered, you want to make sure that you make it invisible. So now it's going to be transparent. You always have to save it as a PNG file. Just another tip for you there as well. If I'm going to do that, I always make sure I just save it at the end. If you want to save it with all of the layers, you have to make sure that you save it in a TIFF file. So just another tip for you as well. So just another quick, just a few other things to kind of get you started. Here is the brush bar. Now, if you want to change, it comes with a few default ones, but you can also choose other ones, which I'll show you here in a second. I use this function the most, this toggle button, and then you can make the size big and small. You know, sometimes I'll be doing something and I want the font or the lettering to be consistent across the page. So I just make either a written or a mental note of what that size was. You can also change the opacity, I think that's how you say it, which it kind of gives it another bit of a fun look as well. Yeah, so if you want to add some new brushes, you can go up to this button here and choose a whole bunch of different ones. Just sort of play around with ones and see what you like. Some of these ones here I added in. This one is pretty important. This is your eraser. You can make it as big or small as you want based on that. So that's really awesome as well. I don't usually use a lot of these smudging tools, but they're an option as well. But there's some pretty fun brushes as well, depending on what kind of like look and vibe. They even got these fun splattery ones and stuff like that. If you want to type something in, you can click the text box up at the top and type in whatever you're doing. Just want to make sure that when you, let me just do something like this so you can see, push OK, and you can make it bigger or smaller. As soon as it pops up, or as soon as you hit enter, this quick transform appears, and then you can change it around. If you need to edit this type later, you want to make sure that you have your open up your layers, hold onto it, and there's a bunch of options here. You can add a layer, delete a layer, and so on. But when you have the type, you can go and actually edit the text layer, which is really helpful, and it will just pop it back up, and then you can go from there. If you have the type layer highlighted, you can't change your color. It won't let you write. So make sure that you always add a new layer. A type always have to be on their own layer. So if you're finding like you can't change the colors or something's going on, just go into your layers and make sure that you have a new layer and that you're not trying to like write on top or write with your pen on the type layer, or the text layer. It's just not going to work. There's lots of other functionalities in this toolbar. There's a backspace, there's a forward, there's a zoom in and out. Usually I just use my fingers for that. The quick transform, this is a crop. Some of these other ones like symmetry and stuff, I don't use quite a lot, but you can certainly play around with them. This one is nice as well. It's creates some different shapes. If you want to change the thickness of those lines, then you can just go in to your brush properties and change that. Now you can see it's really thick around the edges. You just want to make sure that you go back and you unclick that option, or if you go to try to type or write something, it's going to just start to try to make another circle, which can be kind of annoying. There is another color option here, color editor, which I often only use if I'm working with someone and they want me to use very, very specific colors, like a brand palette, then I'll go in and I'll type in the codes. You can see here there's some options as well. But yeah, so that's fun as well if you need to have very specific colors. And that's pretty much it, I think, for a quick overview. All right, so there you go. I hope that was really awesome and interesting for you if you're getting started with Sketchbook Pro. If you are new to sketchnoting and you want a free guide, you can go hop over to sketchnote101.com and pick up one of those, and you can learn a little bit more about the book that's coming out very soon on sketchnoting. And if you like videos like this, feel free to subscribe if you'd like. And if you hit that little bell image, that means you'd get notified when I post videos. So if that's something that interests you as well, you can go ahead and do that. All right, lovely to have you here. I'll see you on the next video, and I hope you have a beautiful day.